So I assume, since this class is a flipped class, it is a flipped class, I assume that you study the slides, you watch the recording, you are ready today to practice and to teach the other how to solve exponential and linear and logarithmic equations. So I assume that you go over these slides, you resolved these examples, you read these guidelines, how to do to solve exponential and logarithmic equations. There are many examples, different ideas. The logarithmic equations, what is the difference between them and the exponential, what to do to solve them, the guidelines, what you should do in general. The most important part here that you must check in the case of logarithmic inequality, logarithmic equations. I also add exponential and logarithmic inequalities. These are in fact for to be used in section 4.1, 4.2, 4.3. You need to use when you solve inequalities, when you want to know where it is below the x-axis or above the x-axis or any horizontal line, any specific line like here, y equals to 3. There are also many solved exercises. I assumed that you went over all of these and you are now ready to practice. Also, there are many solved old exams in the slides. What we will do today, we will start from here. So let's summarize. To solve exponential equation or logarithmic equation, you need to use the one-to-one property. This is what you would use at the end. If you can use it from the beginning, it is so good. But usually you will not be able to do this from the beginning. So what you need to do, you need to isolate the exponential expression alone on one side. And then you need to take the logarithm and then use the laws of logarithms to bring down the exponent, then solve. Similarly, in the case of logarithmic functions, you will use the one-to-one property. But again, it will not be that easy from the beginning. You need to isolate the logarithmic term on one side. To do that, you need to combine the logarithmic terms by using the laws of logarithms. Then write the equation in the exponential form, or in other words, raise both sides to the base that you have. Then solve. Don't forget to check when you have logarithmic equations. Let's start solving the recitation exercises. We will try to solve as many as we can. Solve recitation and all exams. So we need now, how can I choose one of you? I think let's play the game of spin it. Let's choose randomly, one of you randomly, okay? Let's see who is the lucky one to show us how to solve this. Abdulaziz Sufiani, 22. Lucky, Abdulaziz. We are lucky to have you at the beginning, Abdulaziz. Okay, Abdulaziz. How to solve this? Speak, Abi Abdulaziz, please. Speak. How to solve this? I will write for you. Just tell me what to do and I will do it for you. Should we choose another one, Abdulaziz? Let's choose another one to help you. Okay, I will ask you and ask him also to solve. Let's choose another one. So we have Abdulaziz, and let's see who will help Abdulaziz. Sajjad al-Miskin. Are you here, Sajjad? Okay. Sajjad, number 12. The exponential term.
So we have 2, the power 1, that's y by 2.
So you are suggesting to write 4 to the power x plus 2 to the power 1 multiplied by 2 to the power 2x. Good. This is good. It is true. Sajjad? Excellent. So you need to work with the same base. So this is good. Make the bases both to be 4 or both to be what? 2. What do you prefer? 2, it's okay. So this 4 to the power x, it is indeed what? 2 to the power 2, all to the power x. So it will be 2 to the power 2x. Now we have the same base. Next, Abdulaziz and Sajjad, what we can do? Yes, you are totally right. It is like you have here 1 rial plus 2 rials. So you'll have 3 rials, but it is mathematically done like this. Take this as a common factor. In the next step, you'll have 3. 2 to the power 2x equals to 50. This is what we call isolate the exponential term. Now we isolated the exponential term. The exponential term now is alone on one side. Now, next, what we will do? Let me choose another one to tell us what to do. Thank you, Sajjad, and thank you, Abdulaziz Sufyan. Who is the winner? Hassan Salim. Al Salam. Hassan Al Salam. Okay, Hassan. What to do? What next? What was your serial number? Remind me.
14.
Okay, Hassan Al Salam. So what we will do?
Take log
of both sides, or write it in the logarithmic form. This is in the exponential form. We will write it in the logarithmic form. So what we will do, we will take log of both sides. So it will be log 2 of 2 to the power 2x equals to log 2 of 50 over 30. Right. Next. It will be here 2x equals to log 2 of 50 over 30. This is what I meant, ya shabab, by the logarithmic form. This is the logarithmic form, and this is the exponential form, if you remember how to go from the exponential form to the logarithmic form. When you have log A of B equals to C, this is equivalent to saying that A to the power C equals to what? To B. Okay. Good. Next. Just divide by 2 and we are done. So this is the solution that we are looking for. Okay. Now, what about if it was in the answer, it is in the multiple choice answers. What about if it is log 4 of 50 over 3? Is it correct?
Yes.
Is it the same?
Yes.
It is the same. It is the same. You remember when we said that when we have log, where to write it? When we have log A to the power m of x, this is 1 over m log A of x. So in our case here, A is 2 and m is 2 also. So this is what I did. We have this answer. We have it in terms of log 4, which is the same as a half log 2 of 50 over 3. The same. Yes.
We cannot write it as 50 over 6, right?
50 over? How to write 50 over 6? It's 50 over
3.
Okay, let's go now to the next question and let's see who is going to help us to solve it. Omar Al Khalif, 31. Okay, Omar. Add what?
A.
For both sides, okay. E to the power x plus 15, e to the power negative x equals to 8. You are doing the reverse step. You are going back. In fact, if you have this, if you have it like this, you should write it like this. If I give you this question like this, you should write it like this. So this is backward step. It is not forward. Yes, this is an option. So the exponential, let me make it. We will write the exponential of x as what? U or W or whatever. Good option. So what we will have here? U plus 15.
U
to the power minus x? No. If u is e to the power x, what will be e to the power negative x? So it is better to avoid this confusion. E to the power x plus 15 e to the power x minus 8 equals to 0. Is it correct? It is easy like that. I think it is clear. Now you have the option to multiply both sides by what? By e to the power x, or use the substitution. It is up to you. So you can write this as u plus 15 over u minus 8 equals to 0, where u is e to the power x. You should write this. What is u? Otherwise, what is this u that appears suddenly in the question? Now multiply both sides by what? By the LCD to solve. So you will, it will be u squared plus 15u. Again, we can do that here, Shabab. We can, of course, divide both sides by u, multiply both sides by u and u. Because u here, it is e to the power x, which is not zero. You know that we, if you multiply by zero or divide by zero, we will lose everything. So here, e to the power x cannot be zero, never, ever. Excellent. Next, what we will do?
And find the number, which is minus 5.
Reorder the terms. Now you will do what? What is this called? Factor. So factor. It is u times u. Both of them are negative.
And,
so this means that two factors are zero. It means that u is 5 or u is what? 3. What is u? E to the power x. So. Are we done? Are we done? No, we are not done yet. We didn't solve.
Take
ln of both sides. So it will be ln e with it will be, this is so clear. Just we will write it in the exponential, in the logarithmic form. Ln e to the power x equals to ln 3. Ln e, they are inverses. So we will have here ln 5. And here we have x equals to ln 3. So we have two solutions. Why we need to check here?
Because maybe
you have to be sure. Why we should check? Who said we should check when we have this is exponential equation? Did we square both sides at any stage? You know that for any equation, if you squared both sides, you must check. Also, when you have absolute value, which is in fact square root of x squared. So there is squaring there. Again, you need to check. And when you have logarithmic equation, you must check. Because the argument and the base should be positive, not negative. So in this case, the original equation, in fact, it is exponential. The domain is all the real numbers. X here could be any real value. We didn't square any at any step of the solution. We didn't square both sides. No need to check, but it is better. It is better, it is good to check. The question is it a must or not? For this question, it is not a must, but it is okay. If you have time, you can check. And it is not difficult to check, guys. Just you will both like this, look. For example, to check the 3, it will be e to the power negative ln 3 minus 8. Is it equals to 0? See, this will be 3 plus 15, this will be what? Third, minus 8, right? 3 plus 5 minus 8, 0. You can do the same for the then 5. It is not difficult to check. It's better always to check. Maybe you did a mistake in the solution. So, okay, next question. Let's see who is the winner. Nasser Al-Ghannam, 15. Nasser. Okay, Nasser. In fact, I didn't share the, let me make a new share. I will share the screen, the whole screen. Okay. So, okay, Nasser. What to do, Nasser? Let me choose another one to help you. Abdullah Jahani. Okay, Abdullah, 16. So we have here 16 and 15 and 16. Okay, please tell us what to do to solve this logarithmic equation. Nasser, raise both sides to the power 2. You are right. You are right, totally right. Or in other words, write it in the exponential form. You know, when you have log a of x equals to y, this is equivalent to x equals to a to the power y. So this is what we are talking about. So this will be log 3 of x equals to 2 to the power 4. This is equivalent to what Nasser said, raise both sides to the power what? To the power 2. So you will get log 3 of x equals to 2 to the power 4, which is what? 16. Next, let Abdullah Al-Jahni help. Again, what will do, Abdullah? X equals to 3 to the power 16. What you did? You just write it in the exponential form. Or in other words, raise both sides to the 3. You raise 3 to for both sides as a power. So you will have here X equals to 3 to the power 16. Who knows 3 to the power 16 equals to what? You need a calculator with so many digits to be able to find that. So this is the exact value of the solution. Great. Let's go to the next question. Question number 2. Let's see who is lucky to solve this one. Asad Advesi. Okay, Asad. Is Asad here? Okay, Asad. Think about it, how to solve this. Let me choose another one. Write it down. All of you should try and think about it, because you may be the next one who is going to help Asad. What was your serial number, Asad? 10. Okay. Let's see someone else to help Asad. Ali Al-Khlefi. 25. Okay, ya Ali. Any idea, Ali? Ali and Asad, tell us what to do. We have log 2 square root of x equals to negative square root of log 2 of x. Ali and Asad, any idea? Don't stand still. Try to do anything. No idea, Asad? Ali? So what is that called? No. Square both sides, you mean? Is this Ali Al-Khlefi?
Yes.
Okay, Ali. Square both sides. Raise both sides to the power 2. You mean square both sides. It is good. So let's do that. But I advise you, to the power 2, not taking square root. I advise you to, can you deal with this square root when you have log square root of x? Can you do something about the square root, this square root? This is x to the power what? A half, so it can be by the power's law, it will be out, right? So this is a half of log 2 of x. If we write it this way, I think it will be much better. Now take this square both sides, raise both sides to the power 2. Now, why we were able to deal with the square root here, but we are not able to deal with this square root, because here the square root or for the whole log. So here you have the log, all the logarithm is to the power a half, not the argument equals to the power a half. So now let's square both sides. What you will get here? 1/4, and what will be this? It will be log 2 of x all squared equals to, Ali, negative here. What, it will be positive or what? We have negative square root. What we will get here on the right hand side? positive, it'll be positive, negative times negative, it is squaring, it will be positive one. And the square root will gone with two, it will be log two of x. Thank you, Ali. Asad, any idea, Asad, how to continue? Again, this is not, of course, difficult. This is like any equation you have studied before. Any idea from your side, Ali? Let's choose another one to help Ali. Asad, in fact, he is not with us. He didn't prepare for this class, unfortunately, Asad. Saad, Saad al-Rugi, number one. Are you here? Okay, any idea, Saad? Let's take another one. What is wrong with you guys? Faisal Abdul-Jabbar. Faisal Abdul-Jabbar. Are you here? Faisal? What was his serial number, Faisal? Yes, done. Let's choose another one. He's absent. So we have one absent student today. Khalid Al-Kathiri. Is Khalid here?
Yes.
Any idea, Khalid?
Since it's intersection between the...
No, no, where you are? Look what you are, what you are doing. We're still solving this. No, don't do that, Shabab. Please stay with us. Stay with us. Yes.
We can change the base to 4.
Why?
To get rid of the root of x. And
we are done. Where are you? We are here at this step. What you can do here? The base is the same. Why we need to change the base? The bases are the same. Log 2, log 2.
You can divide.
What is your serial number?
5, I think.
5, Khalid Al-Kathiri. Okay, let's take another one. Stay with us, Khalid. Think about it. Write it down, Shabab, if you want to think about it in the right way. Rahman Al-Haydari. Okay, Abdurrahman.
Sorry,
one just a minute.
Well, logic, so transfer the log two of x to the other side.
Then
will equal zero. So I will let u equal log two of x.
What is your serial number?
24.
Excellent, yeah, Abdurrahman. This is what we are talking about. So Abdurrahman, he is saying what? This is 1/4, and this is log 2, and this is log 2. We have it here, and we have it here. We have it here squared, so this will be 1/4 u squared equals to u. What is u? It is log 2 of x. Thank you. Thank you, ya Abdurrahman. Now, what we can do, we can multiply both sides by what? By 4, and then eliminate the right-hand side, so it will be u squared minus 4u equals to 0. This is now a usual equation that you should be able to solve it from 0, 0, 1. You have two factors, the product of them is 0. This means that the first factor is 0 or the second factor is 0. We have u equals to 0 or u equals to 4. What is u? U, it is log 2 of x equals to 0 or log 2 of x equals to 4. Let me choose another students to help me to continue this. Ahmed Hamada. Ahmed Hamada, 32. Are you here, Ahmed? Yes, Ahmed. This means that x equals what? 2 to the power 0, which is 1. This is the exponential form. Thank you. Thank you, Ahmed. And here, x equals what? 2 to the power 4, which is what? 16. So we have x equals to 1 or x equals to 16. So the question is the sum of solutions. What is the sum of solutions? 17. And the answer is what? Is B. Is that right?
No.
We must check. Why we must check? In fact, here we should double check. Yes, why double check here? We have a logarithmic equation. We should always check when we have logarithmic equation. There is another reason. We squared both sides. So here we must check. So these are not solutions yet. They are nominated to be solutions. Are they solutions or not? We need to check. Let's check here. To check, what you need to do? You need to substitute x equals 1 and x equals what? 16 in the original equation here. So let's try x equals to 1. What we will get? Log 2. We have log 2 of square root of 1. Is it equals to negative square root of log 2 of 0? This will be what? Log 2 of what? 1, which is what? 0. And here we have negative log 2 of what is that? This is log 1, not log 0. It is undefined, Shabab. This is, of course, trivial. Log 2 of 1 is 1. Is that right? 0, which is 0. So 0 equals to 0 is 2. So x equals to 1 is a solution. What about x equals 16? Log 2 of square root of 16 equals to negative. I know now it will not be a solution. Clearly, why? Because here we'll have what? A half. This is square root of 16, which is what? This is 4. Let me write it down here. So this will be log 2 of 4. And is it equals to negative? What is log this? It is 4. What is log 2 of 4? 2. Is it equals to negative 2? No. So this is not a solution. So this, the left-hand side is positive, the right-hand side is negative. So it is not a solution. This solution is rejected. So we have only one solution, and in fact, there is no sum to do. It is just one. You raise your hand before you are asking about what?
Can we?
Okay.
After we square both sides.
Okay.
Can we divide both sides by log 2 of x?
Yes, why not?
I did it, but I
got no, you cannot. I got what you are asking about. This is a good question. I forgot to mention this. Your colleague is asking about what? Can we divide here by u? Let me make it easier for you. When you have, for example, here you have u squared equals to 4u. Can we divide both sides by u?
No.
We will lose one of the solutions. If you divide both solutions by u, this will be u equals to what? 4, only one solution. You lost one of the solutions by dividing by an expression that might be 0. Is u can be 0? Yes. Yes, look, u can be 0. Because if you write it this way, u is going to be 0. And here we are, we show it here. So it is one of the solutions, in fact. When you can do that if what you are dividing by is not 0. Like if you are dividing by e to the power x, this is impossible to be 0. So you can divide by it, no problem. Or by a number, by a specific number. Thank you for this remark. Let's go now to the next question. And let's choose a student to help us with this. Suleiman Al-Umar. Okay. Find the intersection points between the following functions. What is the concept in general, Suleiman? In general, a concept, forget about these two functions. If I have a function f and another function g, let's say, this is g of x, this is f of x, y equals f of x, y equals g of x. What will happen at the intersection point? They are equal. This point, it is a point in the xy plane. So here x is the same x in both functions, y is the same y. So how to find this point, to find them, to find the intersection points between two functions? We equate them. We bought them equals to each other. So you will just bought f of x equals to g of x. And this is what we will do right now. We will just put f of x equals to g of x. This is how to solve this question and any question asking about the intersection points between two graphs. Good, so no need to sketch the graphs. Even if you sketch the graph, by the way, even if you said, I will sketch the graph of this one, and then I will sketch the graph of this one and see where they are intersect each other. You will not be able from the graph to exactly determine what is the intersection point. You can know how many are they positive, are they negative, are they between number or less than number, but exactly you need to solve it algebraically. Okay, continue. So we have log 4 of 8 minus log, let me write it here, we need much more space. We have log 4 of 8 minus log 4 of x plus 1 equals to log 16 of x plus 1. This is a very nice question. Yes, what to do? Why do you remember, Shabab, what I told you? When you have log a of x equals to log a of y, this is equivalent to what? This is equivalent to x equals. So the arguments, if the logarithms are the same, then the arguments are the same. So why you cannot write it like this? Some students will do that in the next quiz. I'm sure about that. Why we cannot do this? For two reasons. Reason number one, the bases are not the same. So we don't have the same base. The second one is what? We don't have a single, you should have here a single logarithm equals to another single logarithm. So these we have here two terms, two single logarithms. We should write them as one logarithm, as you mentioned. Thank you. So this, by using the quotient law, this will be logarithm. Do you have the same? They are the same. So it will be 8 over x plus 1, and the base is 4, equals to log 16 of x plus 1. Now, we need to change the base. This is 16. We have a formula that says when you have log a to the power m, this is 1 over m log a to the power x. Do you remember this one? Which is can be written also as what? X to the power 1 over m. So what we will do, this will be what? This is in fact, this 16, it is 4 to the power what? 2. So this will be a half log 4, right? Which can be written now. Can we apply this formula, the one-to-one property? We cannot, because this is still not a single logarithm. In the single logarithm, the coefficient of the logarithm is 1. So what we can do? Raise it to the power what? A half. So we can write this as log 4 of x plus 1 to the power half. Now we have two logs equals to each other, two single logarithms with the same base equals to each other, then the arguments will be the same. 8x plus 1 equals to square root of x plus 1. Okay, now this is not math 002 anymore. We are done, no more logarithms. What we can do? What we can do, guys? Yes, please, anyone? Square both sides. So you will have what? 64 over x plus 1, all squared. You have square root. So how to get rid of that? You will square root of both sides. Do we have absolute value? No, please. When we have a square root of x, when you square the square root, it is equal to what? To x, because x is positive. Otherwise, this is undefined. Don't mix up between it and between the another case. This is, of course, the absolute value. Now, what you will do next? You will multiply both sides by what?
Make x plus 1 equal to 1.
Cross multiply. And of course, x is not negative 1. And for sure, it is not negative 1, because it will not be in the domain, because it is the vertical asymptote. So here, we don't have the denominator equal to 0, because x is not negative 1. Now, you will take the cubic root of both sides, so this will be what? 4 equals to x plus 1, which implies that x equals to what? x equals to 3. So this is the x of the intersection point. You need to check. Why you need to check? Because it is what? It is a logarithmic equation. Both x equals to a to 3 here, what you will get? You will get 4. And you need to simplify this. It will be how to check, where to check. Let me change the color. But before to check, let's check first and then decide. Maybe there is no intersection points between these two graphs because we obtained only one value for x. So now we will have here, let's check this one. So it will be what? What is log 4 of 8? It is log 2 to the power 2 of 2 to the power 3. So this will be a half log 2, which is 3 over 2. Are you with me? This is log 2 to the power 2 minus log 2 of what? 4. Is it equals to log 4 of 2? And here you have 4. Let's see. We will have 3 over 2 minus, what is log 2 of 4? 2. Is it equals to log 4 of 4, which is a half? Yes. It is equals to a half. So it is a solution. Now you need to find the intersection point. The intersection point, it is x and y in the xy plane. What is y? Negative half? Let's check again. We did a mistake here. It is log 4 minus 1 over 8 equals to log 4 of 2. It is x plus 4. So it is 4 here. It is 1, not 2. Yes, thank you for this remark. Log 4 of 4, not log 4 of 2. Okay. We changed that one, but then we will change it. Okay. Now, what is y? How to know that? Just substitute here. Y will be equals to what? Log 16 of 4. 16 to the power what equals 4? A half. So the point of intersection now, it is 3.5. Excellent. Now, I was planning, Shabab, to give you a pop-up quiz about section 4.5. It is just the one question about 4.5. I will delay that to tomorrow. So tomorrow I will give you in 5 minutes, one question from section 4.5 to check that you understood this section very well. Now let's continue. Let's choose another winner. Adnan Al-Ghamidi. Yes. Are you here, Adnan? Yes. Ready to help? Yes. Thank you. Find the inverse of this function.
Y equals e to the power.
Step number one, both y equals to 3 to the power x plus 1. Replace f of x by y. Then
we will raise both sides with log.
This is not called raising. You will take logarithm of both. Or you can say, in other words, write it in what? In the logarithmic form. So which base we will choose here? You can choose any base. What is the best base here, Adnan? Please, Adnan, stay with us. Stay with us. Forget what is in front of you. Yes. The best one is to use the same base, which is 3. So you are right. Then we will get log 3 of y equals to what? X plus 1 by the inverse function property. The log 3 will be canceled with the base 3. Next. What will do next, Adnan? So we need to solve it for x. So we will move 1 to there. So it will be log, let's write it at the beginning, negative 1 plus log 3 of y. Next.
Change x.
Interchange. Excellent, Adnan. And this is the inverse. What about the domain? Did he ask about it? He didn't ask. But if he asks you about the domain, of course, here we have no restrictions here. X here is any real number. But y here is what? Greater than zero. So this will be clearly from here, x is greater than. He didn't ask about it. So this is why we don't need to do anything if he didn't ask about the inverse, if it is not asked. But of course, if you are afraid that it is not one-to-one, you have to be careful. But of course, these functions, the exponential and the logarithmic, they are one-to-one. And this is the solution. Next, let's see. Ahmed Al-Khalifa, 26. Is Ahmed here? Okay, Ahmed. How to find the inverse of this one? Step number one, always. No, step number one, both y instead of the function. This is step number one. Then? How? Write it in the exponential form. 2 to the power y equals to x minus 1. This is equivalent to raising both sides as a power for 2. Okay? Next. Solve it for x. So we will write x equals, move that to there. So it will be 2 to the power y plus 1. And now interchange. This implies that what? The inverse of this function is 2 to the power x plus 1. It is expected. If you have a logarithmic function, it is expected to have the exponential, of course, function. Just it is about how it looks like. What is the exact form of this one? Excellent. Now we have an old exam question here that is from section 4.3, but it can be solved with the ideas of 4.5. You can solve it with the ideas of 4.3. It's okay. You can sketch the graph here. He's asking about the graph of a function that lies below the x-axis. So you can sketch the graph and see where it is below the x-axis, for instance. But to know, you need in that case to what? To find the y-intercept. You need to solve for y equals 0. So you need to solve this equation, which is what? Which is logarithmic equation. So this is one way. The best way is to do what? Let's ask someone to help us with that. Because also I mentioned in the solved exercises, some exercise about this concept. We have here number 6, Abdurrahman. Abdurrahman, number 6. Okay, Abdurrahman. What to do? Let me, ya shabab, pause the recording for a while and take the attendance of the remaining students. Let's resume, Abdurrahman. Any idea, Abdurrahman?
No,
by the ideas of 4.5, not by graphing. What does it mean below the x-axis? This is the x-axis, guys. When you are above, this is the y-axis. When you are above the x-axis, what will happen? When you are below the x-axis, what will happen? Above, look at y. Y is what? Positive. So wherever you are above the x-axis, y is positive. Wherever you are below the x-axis, y is what? So here we have below the x-axis means that y is less than 0. Okay? Now, what is y? Our function. So we have here log of 1 minus x less than 0. This is now the inequality that we need to solve. You need to remember what I told you before. If you have log a of x less than log a of y, this is, of course, in 4.5. This is if and only if what? X less than? Provided that a is greater than 1. If a is less than 1, it will be the opposite. If a is less than 1, greater than 0, it will be greater than. Okay? So you can apply this idea here, or you can apply, of course, you can raise both sides to the power what? 10. The another idea is to raise both sides to the power 10, and with the same idea, you will get, of course, that 1 minus x is less than what? 1, right? This is, of course, absolute value inequality, 1001. This means what? 1 minus x is less than 1 and greater than negative 1 at the same time. Now solve this double inequality. You have negative x less than what? 0 greater than negative 2. Multiply both sides by negative. It will be x less than 2 greater than 0. I did. In fact, I did two steps, yes, in one step.
This is x greater than 0, less than 2, which is the same. Now, is the answer is A?
No,
the answer is not A. Check. The answer is B. Why? So I did it like this because I want you to be aware about such mistakes. When you use algebraic solution, don't forget that to consider here, when we're talking about y, we are talking about x in the domain. So it should be in the domain of the function. What is the domain of the function? What is inside should be what? Strictly greater than zero. What is the solution of this inequality? 1 minus x is not 0, which means that x is not 1. So always keep in this in mind and you will not do any mistake. So this means that the answer is B. Okay. Thank you. And that's it. That's all for today. See you tomorrow, inshallah.